After breakfast and jump-starting one of our land cruisers, we set off for the day of four-wheeling through the Messum Crater to the Brandberg. First, we drove on the salt road, constructed entirely from compacted sand and salt, an abundant commodity due to the huge nearby salt works, and then enjoyed a little beach driving on the skeleton coast. Leaving the main dirt road, we made our way to the Messum Crater. The tracks in the area meander through the very sensitive lichen fields of the NAMIB. More than 18,000 lichen species have been identified worldwide, and Namibia hosts at least 100 different species, many of them found right here in the gravel desert surrounding the crater. We stopped to admire our first Welwitchia, only to find that there are hundreds of them spread out over the gravel flats on the way to the crater. Weird, peculiar, wonderful, strange, bizarre, fascinating, and of course unique are the kinds of words that I use to describe the Welwitchia Mirabiles. It is one of the few things on earth that can truly claim to be one of a kind. There really is nothing like it. Carbon dating tells us that on average, Welwitchias are 500 to 600 years old, although some of the largest specimens are thought to be 2,000 years old. As we explore this inhospitable environment further, we are surprised to find more plant life, insects and ants, and even the evidence of antelope, which I use to demonstrate the Bok Drolliki Spoeg competition.
This is a klipspringer pup. The klipspringer is that very small antelope, so the pup is quite a bit smaller than the impala. Here's hoping he can spin it just as well.
Wow, it's like a watermelon seed.
Like that. Jim?
Yeah,
you want
to help
me?
Nope.
You win.
We seized the opportunity to get some remarkable footage of this incredible place with my drone. The vastness is impressive, but the emptiness almost spiritual and overwhelming. In the whole day of exploring the Messum Crater, we never saw another vehicle or person. Landed the drone and we continued our journey to the center of the crater, coming across this sign at a T-junction in the tracks. Loosely translated, it says, "You're screwed." Top of the cauldron wall of the central volcano rim and launched the drone again. We were stunned into silent reverence by the incredible beauty of the sanctuary in the middle of God's creation. The 25 kilometer diameter Messum Crater is composed of both intrusive and extrusive rocks. It is between 132 and 135 million years old. The intrusions date back to the breakup of the Gondwana supercontinent 130 million years ago. The center part of Messum's volcano has collapsed, creating some of the most amazing moonscapes imaginable, the enormity of the surroundings almost unfathomable. The crater was named after a German ship captain, William Messum, who was an explorer of the coastal regions of southern Africa between 1846 and 1848. Unstabilized video clip is a good representation of what the driving was really like. We continued our adventure, driving in the wide, dry Messum riverbed for many, many more kilometers, when finally we saw our next stop for the next two nights, the Brandberg mountain. Just before the town of Uis, we turned off on the track to the Brandberg White Lady Lodge. We stopped to give some water to the family on the side of the road. If we were surprised by the Cape Cross Lodge on the Skeleton Coast, we were even more impressed by the beautiful lodge in the middle of the desert, nestled literally almost on the side of the Brandberg, Namibia's highest mountain. A beautiful sight after a full day of hard four-wheeling through the desert. The lodge offers 15 basic chalet-style rooms and several campsites located in the Uchab riverbed, which is frequented by the elusive and rare desert elephants. The yellow light just before sunset in Africa always moves me. Everything looks so beautiful in this light. Just look at my friends here, for instance. After a lovely three-course dinner in the excellent restaurant, we are entertained by the staff. Yet another amazing experience here in the middle of the desert in southern Africa.